Am I allowed to ask you questions?
Sure.
Okay, so at one point, what did our collaboration fall in the spectrum of your co-write?
I think we were kind of right in the middle.
Okay.
And our song was different, and the process was different than any of the others.
Because you were saying it was like you were going on all these blind dates, and I was just wondering how I ranked.
If you're going to start a song from scratch, sometimes the best person is someone who you're starting from scratch with.
And the fact that you don't know the person actually, for me, kind of frees it up.
I feel like everybody you would collaborate with would be slightly different in the way it goes down.
It's not all my influence, it's not all your influence, it's actually both of us throwing ideas against each other.
I think that variable can bring something out of you that you wouldn't stumble on by yourself.
Totally. I'm really inspired by the classics and by folk and pop and early rock. I love that sound and that energy.
I remember the day we got together, you were vibing on this 50s pop and like early rock and roll pop.
Yeah, I was listening to Brenda Lee, Is It True?
Mm-hmm. And we talked about a mutual love for her.
I love that. Is it true, my love? Whoa! Yeah, and it was such a sassy, I thought, oh, I gotta do something like that.
We got into like scratching out lines and phrases.
Right.
And then it kind of veered into this sort of idea of celebrity obsessed culture and
definitely
things you were,
yes.
At a certain point, I was just trying to keep up with you. Like I was just chasing you around the room trying to pin
trying to pin down
what exactly we were writing about.
Right.
But I think it took me a minute to kind of realize
I wasn't crazy.
Well the verdict's still out on that one, but just like how you like to work and what works for you and the best way to employ your best strengths to the song.
Yes.
But then when we went in to record it, we kind of just did takes and you riffed off the page and just kind of
appreciated that you let me do that because I think a lot of the best things come out of that freedom.
Yeah.
Just being able to explore instead of having somebody put a ceiling on what you do or make you do this thing that way or this thing that way. It just becomes too controlled, and that's when something becomes unartistic. So I fight against that as much as possible.
If I remember right, we had like, you simplified this one in a good way. Like you took, we had like two different phrases, and you're like, no, the song is this.
Right.
Let's just stick to the meat here.
I'm a genius.
Yeah, it's just a roundabout way of people getting around to saying, congratulations, we came to tell you.
Temporary stars like the boulevard. Celebrity feeling saying, oh, you could be me if you want to
to co-write really because I'm looking for people who will bring that essence out in the music.
It's that variable of the unexpected.
Totally.
Can bring something out of you that you wouldn't stumble on by yourself.
I think when you do everything alone, there's a ceiling, there's a limit, there's a narrowness. When you open the door, you know, you're inviting spontaneity, you're inviting brilliance, you're inviting something that you don't control. That artistic lightning, right? And some stuff that takes you up, throws you down, and picks you back up again, right?
And there's a value in that when you're always trying to push yourself to do something different than what you've always done before. Yeah.
Definitely.
And you're blinded by what you
Rachel Fannan, and this has been Talking Shop with the Lovett.